Alright guys, so in this video we're gonna learn about human-computer interaction. Now this is slide 1, introduction to HCI. Now I'm just gonna go through all the headings, and in the next video we're gonna go in detail, or actually I'm gonna give you guys a homework to go in detail. Now what is human-computer interaction? Human-computer interaction is how you interact with the computer. Okay, now we have our course assessment, then we have our semester presentation marks, then we have our textbook that we are going to follow, then we have our reference book, then we have what is interaction design. Okay, this is the main purpose of our video. Outline, explain the difference between good and poor interaction design, describe what interaction design is and how it relates to human-computer interaction and other fields, explain the relationship between user experience and usability, describe what and who is involved in the process of interaction design, outline the different forms of guidance used in interaction design, enable you to evaluate an interactive product, and explain what is good and bad in terms of goals and core principles of interaction design. Okay, then what do we have is we have bad designs. This is an example of bad design. Why is vending machine so bad? Now in this we have our vending machine. Step 1, push any button to start unit. Now this is, they are emphasizing that this vending machine is so bad, we are gonna have to design a better version. Then they have given an example of good design. Then they have given the example of good and bad design. This is a remote on the right, this is a remote on the left that is much more sleek and sexier, and you can hold it in your hand more comfortably. Okay, what do we have after that is what to design, need to take into account these factors and need to optimize the interaction users have with a product. Then we have the example of novel interface. You can see this lady is looking to the right and the indicator is blinking, and as she looks on the left the indicator is blinking to the left. Okay, and then we have understanding users needs. Then we have activity example, how does making call differ when using a cell phone, Viber or Skype. Okay, so they're saying that using Viber and Skype is pretty much different than using cell phone. Consider the kinds of user, types of activity and context and use. What is interaction design? Okay, this is the definitions by two people. Okay, then goals of interaction design, develop usable products, involve users in design process. HCI and interaction design, you can see this is the chart of the interaction design. And then we have relationship between ID, HCI and other fields, academic disciplines contributing to psychology, social sciences, computer sciences, engineering, ergonomics, informatics. Then we have relationship between ID, HCI and other fields. Then we have relationship between ID, HCI and other fields more continued. Then we have this working in multidisciplinary teams. As you can see there are four persons, they all have different ideas, and there are some benefits and there are some disadvantages if of the situation, but the ultimate outcome is definitely good. And then we have what do ID professionals do in interaction design business. These are the some factors that you can study later on after watching this video or by pausing this video. I'm just gonna go walk through this slide real quick, then we got ahead to the slide 2. Our cultural difference is important. You can see there are two dates in this versus this, which should be used in international services and online forms. Why is it that certain products like iPod are universally accepted by whole forms, all the people, whereas websites are reacted to differently by people in different cultures? Okay, so there are comparing iPod with different universe, different websites. They are comparing iPods with websites. Websites are less accepted socially by people, iPods are accepted more. Then we have usability and user experience goals. You can have a look at this. Then we have design principles, some points that we should follow while designing anything. Then we have to get the feedback of the people, what design we have done. Then we have to follow some constraints. Then we have to stay consistent. Then we have internal and external consistency within the corporate. Then we have affordances. What does that mean? To give a clue, these are the points that you have to follow. Then we have some key points that we have to keep into consideration. And that is the end of our slide one. I'll see you guys in the slide two. If you cannot understand something, you can Google and you can pause the video and Google. The whole slide is in front of you. I'm gonna look you guys in the next video with something more better and then chapter one. That would be understanding and conceptualizing interactions.